Felicity back again with another video, a process video for hip kits using the July 2017 kit. And ooh, I love this one. Yes. I wish actually I had two of these kits because they're just so beautiful. There's so many beautiful things in it, so many different exclusive products, and love, love, love. So this is an exclusive paper in the kit, which is designed by one of our designers, Erin. And it's just beautiful. I love, love, love the paper. So I wanted to, I guess, try and keep as much of that paper as what I can. So I decided to cut some circles out down the bottom because, and I think I show you later on, I got all a bit mixed up and yeah, with this page, but now I've gone haywire here. Oh, nope, there we go, photos. it ends up being for the sketch challenge. And I think I've gone to get the sketch to show you. There it is. Hello. There's my sketch. So I end up flipping it, as you can see, just 90 degrees to be able to suit. So that's out of the road. It's for the sketch. And I'm using the July kit. Right. Got it? Yep. Good. Right. Oh, some days, like, I seriously should not do voiceovers on a Monday. I really shouldn't, because my mind just can't get it together. My brain, not my mind, my brain. See, there you go. So yes, I've decided to add circles down the bottom, and I kind of didn't have any direction, didn't really know, just kind of went with it. Of course, I love the scallops and had to add them in, and I pulled out the pink paisley Paige Evans paper as well from the June kit, just because it just matched perfectly. So I was like, no, I need a strip of that in there. And then I used it as a template and cut it out, you can see, from the other exclusive paper designed by Erit as well. And I hope I'm saying her name correctly. Forgive me if I'm not. It's Monday after all, like I said. yes. Now, I know this seems really weird and you're probably thinking, why on earth am I using just a plain old glue stick? I'm using a plain old glue stick for one or a couple of reasons, but one of them being is because I'm still not 100% sure if this is all going to end up right in the end, or I guess if I want to move it or if I can't get it balanced. So I'm like, let's just put a little bit of glue down, because then it's easy for me to lift up and move if I need to. And also, secondly, is me being me, I knew that I was going to add a ton of stitching in there, hand stitching, machine stitching. So, and I don't like to have, I guess, a lot of glue underneath it. I don't find the glue very good for my needles. Although a needle for a sewing machine is quite inexpensive to replace, I just don't like to try and use too much glue or sticky stuff underneath. So hence why I just use a plain old cheap glue stick, because everything ends up being adhered down fairly well because of the stitching. So now I've pulled out more exclusives, which is from Kim Watson. And you can see there, the Relax is like a puffy sticker that she designed. That ampersand sign is like a chipboard that Kim designed. The arrow is a wood veneer that she designed, and the little flower and the harm. Yeah, it's all exclusive. Like the frame, just like, oh, it's so, so cute. I just love it, all of it. The colors are bright, they're fun. Just really, a really, really easy kit to work with. I mean, most of them are, don't get me wrong, but I don't know. I just absolutely love this kit. Really, really do. So now I'm just playing around with a pack of embellishments that came with the kit and just fiddling, as I do a lot of for a long, long time. Yes. Anyway, and I'm sorry if you can hear a little bit of wind coming through the microphone. I've got the window open behind me because it's a lovely warm winter's day here again, and the breeze is just beautiful. After a little bit of rain yesterday and a very foggy morning, it's very pleasant weather today. I should be out in my garden, shouldn't I? I've got so many flowers out there to pick. Roses, sweet peas, snapdragons, cornflowers. And also there's like a ton of weeds I need to pull out. We'll do that another day. We'll stick to scrapbooking for the moment, hey. But I do love my flower garden. Yeah, so there you can see that that's more of the chipboard exclusives. So on the left, I've got my tray, which is all full of the hip kit embellishments. And I'm just pretty much going through it, just looking for what is going to suit what's colors. Yeah. And because this page, like, it's a picture of little old me, and it's kind of a fun picture. Nothing, I guess in some ways, yes, it does definitely have meaning behind it, because at first I was going to do my journaling, which you'll see later on, around one of the circles. But then I decided to do my journaling on the back of the page. Now, I don't have a problem with that at all. Yes, you don't see it when you first glance, I suppose, at the page or in an album. But perhaps, like, I guess, how am I going to explain it? The journaling that I did is from a very personal experience that I've just been through. And I really didn't want to share it, to be honest. I just didn't. I wanted to keep the journaling, and I wanted to have it there because I know that, you know, even in 4 weeks' time, 12 months' time, 6 months' time, whatever, to look back and to read that will be quite, you could say, encouraging. And even later when my boys go through the albums and find this page when I'm in a grey and in a nursing home, they're going to appreciate it. So it's just part of life, and I wanted to document it. And I mean, that's, yeah. And I probably don't document my own personal as such experiences or things like that enough, because, you know, the kids need to know what we as adults and as parents have faced, because they're probably going to go through something similar. And if we don't say, oh yeah, we went through that, then they're going to think, well, hold on, is this really normal? You know what, like, can you understand what I'm saying? So yeah, I like to be able to share as much as I can, just so that the kids know that, yeah, this is what happens with life. This is what happens as a parent. This is what happens as a mother, father, whatever it is. So yeah, it was quite some personal journey, and it was very therapeutic for me. So I ended up doing it, yeah, on the back. And I, of course, as I said, it's quite personal, so I don't end up showing it. I could have and then just blurred it out, and I was like, it's just blank on the back with just stitching behind it from the hand stitching and sewing machine. So it's quite messy, so I won't show you. Rightio. Oh, I have admired for so long, you know, like the pie charts. And I was like, I'm so doing this time. Oh. And I did. I was a little bit nervous because I'd never done it before. But it's cool. I love it. I just, yeah, it's different. It's fun. So I'm doing it again. So, yeah, I just used the exclusive papers and chopped it up. And it kind of adds really cool layers. And because of the brads that come in the kit, they just held it together perfectly. So I really, really love it. And I know the other page that I've got coming too, I sort of still stuck with my circle theme because I was just having a great old time. So wait till you see that one. That's another cool one. And those little clips that you can see, there's one tucked behind the photo with a white heart that says love. And I think there's the dotty one up the top photo near the word relax and the flower. They're like little clips that came from Bella Boulevard. But I use them just as, you know, as embellishment elements and just tuck it in behind, and they look really cute. So don't, I guess when you pull them out, don't think that you have to use them as an actual clip. Just tuck them in, chop it off if you have to. Like, it doesn't, there's no right or wrong way. So here's this tape. It came in, I think it was the Project Life kit. It is so pretty. It matched perfectly. I put it down and went, nah, too much. Took it off. It's just part of my process. So now I come in and I'm a good girl and cover up my photos. Yes, doesn't happen often, but I did this time. And I use my shimmers that came in the color kit and just splatter it about. I just use pink and yellow. I could have done the green as well, but I was like, oh, there's too much color here going on. Let's just stick to two and keep the pink and the yellow as the main focal colors, I suppose. And then this strip, which I've cut off with the camera, sorry Dory, is the paper strip from the bottom of the exclusive paper. And I never chuck those out because they are just really, really great for layering and they're just so pretty. But I don't end up using it on this page. But yeah, that was the idea. I was thinking I needed to balance it. But in the end, it kind of balances itself out. I was thinking along the lines of, oh, it's too heavy as such down the bottom. I need to add something up the top to balance it. But in the end, yeah, it looks fine. Well, I say so myself. And look, I'm happy with it, and that's the main thing. Hey, like when you create, make sure that you're happy with it. Don't try and please somebody else or try and keep up with someone else. You're doing it purely for yourself, for enjoyment, for fun. So just always bear that in mind. I pretty much can't stress that enough when you're creating. Just make sure you're doing it for you, not trying to be the next person. So then I just do two little tucks there just to add a little bit more interest and texture, and it just gives it a little something up the top there as well. And that's a pink paisley paper with pink hearts on the back, and it matches perfectly. Yes, yes, yes. But no, I really, really love how this turned out. Pretty thrilled. Might have to go and pop it up on my wall with some other pages. But that means then I've got to take one down to put that one in the frame. Oh, first world problems. Yes. Anyway, I'm coming up near the end. So if you've bared with me with my Mondayitis video, thank you very much for being here and watching. Links will be in the comments. Leave me a comment if you've got any questions. Yeah. And I will see you in my next video. Enjoy your week. Bye.